Mari Lwyd, horse of frost, star horse, and white horse of the sea, is carried to us. The dead return. Those exiles carry her. They who seem holy and put on corruption. They who seem corrupt and put on holiness. They strain against the door. They strain toward the fire which fosters and warms the living. The living who have cast them out from their own fear, from their own fear of themselves, into the outer loneliness of death, rejected them and cast them out forever. The living cringe and warm themselves at the fire, shrinking from the loneliness, that singleness of heart. The living are defended by the rich warmth of the flames, which keeps that loneliness out. Terrified, they hear the dead tapping at the panes. Then they rise up, armed with the warmth of firelight and the condition of scorn. It is New Year's night. Midnight is burning like a taper. In an hour, in less than an hour, it will be blown out. It is the moment of conscience. The living moment. The dead moment. Listen. Oh, white did the frost and the breath-blade panes, and the starlight fire within, and our Mari is white in her starry reins, starved through flesh and skin. It is a skull we carry, in the ribbons of a bride, bones of the night frost parry, bones of the fire inside. None can look out and bear that sight, none can bear that shock, the Mari shadow is too bright. Her brilliance is too black. None can bear that terror when the pendulum swings back.